Milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach
you. Hey! What the hell are you doing out here?
Nothing. I'm just making my shake.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back. So today is Friday, July the 17th. So it has been now 1 week since I had VSG surgery at the surgery center up there at Atlanta Bariatric. There's been quite a few changes that's taken place in the last week. I have now totally, since the beginning, starting the liquid diet, everything, I have now dropped 28.6 pounds. So since since June 26th, in 3 weeks, I have now dropped 28.6 pounds. This morning when I got on the scale, I was 329.8. That is the first time that I have seen a 2 for that second number in at least 10 years. So I have been all above the 330 mark for over 10 years now. I'm definitely looking forward to getting below the 320 mark, because that's the lowest that Sabrina has ever seen me, is 320 pounds. So once I get below there, that'll actually be the lowest that I've been in the last 12 years. So that's definitely something I'm looking forward to. This is, when I'm talking about the diet plan that I'm having, this is what my doctor, my nutrition staff has set for me. Everybody's plan may be a little bit different. So I had the 2 weeks of the modified liquid diet leading up to surgery. The day before surgery was only clear liquids. The day of surgery, only clear liquids, which I really didn't eat a whole lot. Starting the day after surgery, I was on full liquids, which consisted of 3 protein shakes a day. That's it. So I could also have 2 liquid snacks. Most of the time I was struggling to get down the 3 protein shakes, so it was really no point in having the liquid snacks. I did have a couple sugar-free popsicles, which helped out immensely. But yeah, I will tell you right now, yes, I've been hungry because of, really all I've had is the protein shakes. And we'll go over which protein powder it is that I use and everything coming up. But yeah, right now, since surgery, I've dropped right at 12 pounds, and I'm at 28.6 since for the last 3 weeks. So that's phenomenal. It's completely mind-blowing to think that I've lost that much. Side effects. I am very tired. I have noticed that come midday, I just want to take a nap. And that's due to the lack of calories and everything that I'm having. So that's to be expected. So when you're going through this journey, know those first few days, you're going to be tired. That first week or so, you're going to be tired. I'm tired right now. I could really go to sleep right now without any problems. Tomorrow starts soft foods. So I can have scrambled eggs, refried beans, things of that nature, a lot smaller portions. But I'll be able to have some of that, so hopefully that'll help with some of my energy level. So just wanting to give you a 1 week update on how things are going, and also kind of talk about the protein that I use. So yeah, just stay tuned. We're going to keep this on going. So what we're going to do today is I'm kind of go over some of the protein shakes that I've been having since surgery. For this whole week after surgery, I've been on 3 protein shakes a day. I'm using the Bariatric Advantage protein powder. So it's the high protein meal replacement. I also have a Bariatric Advantage Fusion that I'm using as well. I haven't opened it yet. It came with my bariatric kit from the surgery center. But both of them I got in vanilla. And the reason why I did that is I've heard way too many people that got the fancy flavors, the chocolate peanut butter, the fruity flavors. After having them as many times as you're having to drink these things, they got old quick. So I went with just the plain vanilla,
and I can add various things to them to doctor them up a little bit, if you would. The vanilla is fine just as is, but I'm going to go over just one of the things that I'm doing during this stage. It's also important, one of the things my doctor's office told me to start with for the first week, do not use a blender. Now, granted, this is just from my doctor's office, but I've heard of other people that use blenders. It put too much air in the shake, and then it caused problems with gas pains and things of that nature. So what I'm going to do right here, just show you a quick way. Take this from vanilla to chocolate. Kind of gives it a little bit of a variance to where you're not having to have the same old, same old. So as I mentioned before, I have two different meal replacement shakes here. I have Bariatric Advantage and Bariatric Fusion. The Bariatric Advantage is what we purchased for the pre-op diet portion of it. And the Bariatric Fusion is what came with my kit when I had my bariatric kit. Both of them are very, very similar when it comes to the calories, the fat, the carbs. Everything is almost identical. I have not opened up this Bariatric Fusion yet because I'm still working on the Bariatric Advantage one. I don't like opening something if I haven't finished the one prior, but both of them are vanilla flavor. They work great just as is, but today I'm going to show you how I make them chocolate. All right, so for this first one right here, as you see, there's not much powder left in here, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the scoop that comes with it, and I'm going to get two scoops and be kind of slightly rounded off a little bit. I'm going to get two scoops of the protein powder. That's how much normally goes inside one of the shakes. But what I'm also going to do to make this chocolatey is I have 1 teaspoon. I'm going to put 2 teaspoons of just unsweetened baking cocoa. Put those 2 teaspoons in there and then kind of mix this on up. The reason why I'm mixing it up beforehand, I've tried putting it in there, you know, mixing the protein powder and then shaking it up, but the cocoa powder seems to stick and cause clumps. I really didn't like that too much. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking, mixing this all up. That way when I put it in my shaker bottle, it will blend together a little bit better and give it a nice consistency. All right, so I have my original shaker bottle here. As you see, there's this little line that I put on there. That's marking the 8 ounce indicator. Because when I make these shakes, put 8 ounces in there. I always take the little whisk out and everything. And then what I'm going to be using, moving this off to the side, I've just got Kroger skim milk. And I'm going to fill up the skim milk to the line. Went just a little bit above the line, but it's not, I mean, it's just a hair over. So now that I've done that, what I'm going to do is take the powder that I've already made and put it into the shaker bottle. Once I do that, put the whisk in there, put the lid on, and then just start shaking it up. And you'll see it starts turning, just looks like chocolate milk. That's a good way, and you also notice it started just above the 8-ounce mark. It's done brought it on up here to close to the 16-ounce mark. So it's on up there close to 2 cups. But that shake right there will take me right at about an hour and a half maybe to drink. If it's a little bit too thick, I'll add some ice to it. Starting next week, when I can use the blender, I'll also put some fruit in there, maybe some strawberries, banana, blueberries, but then I'll be able to blend them up to put them in there.